The Tower of Half
Blood. This is the prologue from the Canterbury Tales by Chaucer. And first I'm going to do the modern translation of it, and then I'll try and read it in the original 14th century English. So this is the modern translation. One fair April with his showers sweet has pierced the drought of March to the root's feet, and bathed each vein in liquid of such power, its strength creates a newly springing flower. When the west wind, too, with his sweet breath, has breathed new life in every copse and hedge and heath, into each tender shoot, and the young sun from Aries to Taurus on his run, and those small birds begin their melody, the ones who sleep all night with open eye, then nature stirs them up to such a pitch that folk long to go on pilgrimage, and wandering travelers tread new shores, strange strands, seek out fair shrines renowned in many lands, and specially from every shear's end of England to Canterbury they went, the holy blessed martyr there to seek, who has brought health to them when they were sick. And this is the way Chaucer wrote it back in the 14th century. Quam fat aprile with his surest thoughte, the drooped march hath per sento ferote, and budded every vein in switchly pur, in of which virtue engendered is the flour. Quam zephyrus ek with his suete breath, in spirit hath in every point and head, the tendre propes, and the young zone hath in the ram its halve course erone, and smalle fules maken melodie, hath slept in all the nicht with open ear, supplicet hem nature in courages, tan longen forth to go non pilgrimages, and palmeres for to seken stronges strondes, to ferne harves cool in sondre londes, and scarcely from every shire's ende of England to Canterbury they wende, the holy blissful martyr for to seke, that hem hath holfen quam the day were seke.